Welcome to another session on Mass Good channel. Today we are going to resolve a question taken from past YEC question. The probability of a boxer becoming a world champion whilst under 30 years of age is 2/3. Find the probability that in a group of 10 boxers all under 30 years old, not more than 2 will have a world title. We are going to highlight some important words or group of words here. First, we have the probability that a boxer will become a world champion, 2/3 there. And the number of trials we have here, we have to underline 10 boxers. And then we're going to have not more than 2 will have a world title. These highlighted group of words are very important to resolving this question. Now, let's move on. Okay, let the probability that a boxer will become a world champion be P. Alright, then P will be equal to 2/3, that is 2 over 3. Then we're going to introduce another one, the complement, which is going to be Q. Let's use Q, and it's going to be that is 1 minus 2 over 3. This will give us 1 over 3, right? You can find that out and see. 1 minus 2 over 3 will be 1 over 3, correct? Okay. Now, this is Bernoulli trials. And in Bernoulli trials, we have the probability of certain events where we have R successes to be equal to, we have the number of events combination, the number of successes, and then we have P, which is the probability of success raised to the power of R, then Q raised to the power of N minus R. So this is what we use to resolve questions on binomial distribution, that is involves Bernoulli trials. So in this case now, we are going to have N to be equal to 10, since there are 10 boxers involved in these trials. Then R will be equal to the number of successes, and this we are going to find out. And I think these are the basic ones. Now the question states further, not more than 2 will have a world champion. If we have that not more than 2 will have a world champion, it means that 2 or below will have a world champion. So it means that the number of successes can either be 2, 1, or 0, none at all. So these are the possibilities we have. So we can have 2, 1, or 0. So it means that the probability that not more than 2 will have a world title will be the probability that 2 will have a world title, or 1 will have a world title, or 0 will have a world title. So if we denote the probability that Let's say zero will have a word title by, let's say, A0. We can denote the probability of one of the buzzers will have a word title by E1, and the probability that two will have a word title with E2. So what we are going to do here is simply find the probability that none of the buzzers will have a word title. We find the probability that only one of them will have a word title, and the probability of only two of them will have a word title. Then we're going to sum everything together to answer this question. So we go this way. The entire probability now, let's say the probability that we are going to have, let's say E. Now, since we represented everything with E1, E2, E0, E0, so let's use E, then will be equal to the sum of the probability that, of A0 plus the probability of A1 plus the probability of A2. So these are what we're going to find out and sum together. So recall that for each of these, we're going to have these to be equal to the probability that none will have a word title. Let's go back to this. It will be a total of 10. Out of the total of 10, none will have a word title. Then P raised to the power of 0. And remember, let's quickly substitute instead of bringing in values and values upon values. We have that our P is equal to 2 over 3 already raised to the power of 0 multiplied by Q is 1 over 3 and it is raised to the power of 10 minus 0. Then we are going to add it to 10 again, combination. Okay, let's use another ink for this. Combination 1, this time around, times 2 over 3, always to the power of 1 this time, times 1 over 3 all raised to the power of 10 minus 1. All right. And then we're going to have plus 10 combination 2 times 2 over 3 raised to the power of 2 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 minus 2. All right, we can now move on to resolve further. We have 10 combination 0 is simply 1 times 2 over 3 raised to the power of 0. Any number raised to the power of 0 is 1 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 minus 0. We're going to have 10. Then we add it to the next parts, plus 10 combination 1 is equal to 10 times 2 over 3 raised to the power of 3 is the same thing, then times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Then we add to the next one, plus 10 combination 2 to 10 factorial over 2 factorial, that is 10 minus 2, 8 factorial. So that will be equal to 10 times 9 factorial. 10 times 9 times 8 times 8 factorial over 2 times 8 factorial. This can go. So we're going to have 10 times 9 over 2. Okay, let's have that. 10 times 9 over 2. And we simply go cancel this. Multiplied by 2 over 3 raised to the power of 2. We can express that directly as well, so to minimize, a space. Okay, we have 2 raised to the power of 2, which is 4, over 3 raised to the power of 2 equal to 9, multiplied by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 minus 2 is equal to 8. All right, we can now move on. You're going to have 1 times 1 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10. We're going to have 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 simply, plus, okay, we're going to have, we can manipulate something here. We're going to have 10 times 2. Okay, let's have it as 10 times 2 times 1 over 3 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 9. So as to simplify, 10 times 1 over 3, 2 times 1 over 3 is the same thing as 2 over 3. So, plus, you're going to have 2 here, 1, 2 here, 2, 9, 1, 9 here, 1. Alright, so we're going to have 10 times 2, which should be equal to 20, times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. So this will be equal to 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 plus 10 times 2 will give us 20 times 1 over 3 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 9. According to the law of indices, we can simply add up. We're going to have 1 over 3 or raised to the power of 10. We add their index plus 20 times 1 over 3 or raised to the power of 8. Okay, let's treat this like algebra. We have 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 plus 20 multiplied by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10. We're going to have 21 is like 1 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 plus 20 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10. So we can have 21 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 plus 20 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. In this case, we're going to factor out a certain number which is common to both. 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10, the lowest is 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8, so we can bring it out. So we have 1 over 3 or raised to the power of 8 into, we're going to have now 21 1 over 3 raised to the power of 10 divided by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. We're going to have 21. Then 1 over 3 raised to the power of 2. Going to be left with 2 then. Plus 20, 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8 divided by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. We're going to have 20. All right, we're making progress. Okay, so we can further have it as 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8 into 21 times 1 over 3 raised to the power of 2 is the same thing as 1 over 3 times 1 over 3 plus the 20 of cars. At this point, we have 1 over 3, 3 in 3, 1, 3 in 21 is 7, because this is over 1. All right. Okay. We are simply going to have the expression as 1 over 3 or raised to the power of 8 into 7 times 1 times 1, which is 7 over 1 times 3 times 1, 3 plus 20. Of course, this is going to be over 1. Let's quickly express this and see what we're going to have. We are going to have 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. Into the LCM is 3, 3 in 3, that is 1, 1 times 7, 7, plus 3 divided by 1, that is 3, 3 times 20, we're going to have 60. All right. Let's have this down. Making progress. So we're going to have the probability to be equal to 1 over 3. Sorry. 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8 into 7 plus 60 is going to be 67 over 3. All right, this can be further expressed as 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8 multiplied by, we factor out 67 over 1 multiplied by 1 over 3. Take a look at this expression. It will give us the same fact as we had over there. 67 times 1, we're still going to have this 67. And 3 times 1, we're still going to have this 3. So we are only simplifying the expression, expanding the expression, so to say. Now we have 1 over 3 here as well, multiplied by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 8. You know that this is raised to the power of 1. Any number or expression raised to the power of 1 is the same. So 1 is always taken invisible. So we can now have 1 over 3 or raised to the power of 8 plus the 1, which is the power of this 1 over 3. So 8 plus 1, according to the law of indices, if we have the same base, we add their powers. So we have 8 plus 1, which is 9, multiplied by 67. So we can, if you like, turn it, because multiplication is commutative, so we can have it as 67 multiplied by 1 over 3 raised to the power of 9. If you study indices well, you will notice that this expression can be written as 67 times 3 raised to the power of minus 9. And this will be expression, because we told to leave the denominator in power of 3. So we have our probability found. So the probability that in a group of 10 buses, all under 30 years old, not more than 2 will have a word title will be equal to 67 times 3 raised to the power of negative 9. Thanks for watching Maths Guru's video. Please don't forget to subscribe. It's very important. And follow us as we release the next video online. Thank you. Bless you.